For you, what is the true spirit, the essence of metal?
Essence of metal? I don't know. I mean, what is the essence of metal? I look back at myself. I mean, I love playing hard rock, metal, fusion, pop, soul, whatever. I like play music, you know. I keep comparing this to food a little bit and sports, because I love hamburgers, but I can't eat burgers every single day. But what's the essence? You got to have the love for and passion for it, you know. And there's a lot of bands and there's a lot of people out there, artists, that really do have that. But rock and roll, yeah, they'll never die. That's for sure, you know. Pretty much everything was unique with Lemmy. And I just did an interview earlier. A lot of people, you know, they saw him as a bass player slash guitar player. But to play with this man, he was extremely good playing. He was so heavy, so unique, and he had a certain way of bending notes and getting into breakdowns in music. You know, he was very, very hard to play with in the beginning. But once we got together and we locked in, after, you know, a few years, he was a tremendous bass player and a singer. You know, he was so unique that you can't really put a finger on what exactly made Lemmy, you know. And that's what made him unique, you know. It's easier to say some other musicians, you can say, well, that guy or that girl, she's amazing on scales or chops on drums or whatever. You know about Lemmy? He was just a very, very unique man in all ways, shapes, and forms. And, you know, I don't know what to say more about that. It's, you can't explain it, you know. Why does something taste so good? Why? Little guest appearance here with Saxon, you know. We decided not to do anything except a couple of songs would be nice, you know, which we did today. And
what were your emotions? What were your feelings like?
It's great, you know. I'm just thinking of the actual building and probably a lot of fans in there. You know, these songs have played a lot of times in here, you know, so it's great to sit there on stage and start off overkill again. I never thought I'd do that, so it was great fun. I wouldn't mind to play it an hour and a half more, you know, and get into the real stuff. But we did Ace and Born to Race and Overkill, and you know, and it's with our friend Saxon, you know. We wouldn't do it with anyone else, I don't think. You know, they toured with us on the last tour, and we've done a lot with these guys, so it felt kind of natural to go out and smoke through a few songs, you know.
And do it in America together.
Well, we don't have time. I'd like to. Now we're going to do Scorpions, you know. I'm in full tour with these guys.
You had to turn down Thin Lizzy then.
Yeah, I had to do that.
Was that a tough choice?
Well, Thin Lizzy was six shows, you know. Uh-huh. And Scorpions, we'll be touring for the rest of the year. So we're doing the whole world. And
that's a nice career trajectory. Really, King Diamond to Motörhead to Thin Lizzy to Scorpions. I mean, that's a lot of
knocking in between there.
Oh, yeah.
A couple of years. No, but it's great. And we just finished U.S. and Mexico, came back, and now we start festivals here in Europe, and it's been great, you know. These are great guys, and we know them for many years, and I love their music, and as much as I love Thin Lizzy, you know. Thin Lizzy was one of my favorite bands. I haven't, you know, I played so long with Motörhead, and we were three-piece, and that's a tremendous difference. You know, for instance, really quick, when Phil was doing his solo, I might have to be a little busier on a kick drum. Yeah. Here, I got to think the opposite. You know, I got to be easier on certain things and step into some other stuff. So, but it's a great challenge. I mean, these guys are so nice, and we've known each other for many, many years. And it's a great honor, as I said, to carry the Scorpions flag here, you know. And I wish I could have done the Thin Lizzy shows. It was a bummer for me, but maybe they'll do a 50th anniversary. I don't know. A terrible loss to go from something like that to absolutely nothing. But now with Scorpions, it's great. I got to bring Scorpions in. It's been fantastic. And I'm not ready to put my drumsticks on the shell, you know.
And how long's the Scorpions thing going to
We're
going to
do the whole world now. So we do Asia, South America, we do Israel, we do Europe again, and now we got to finish up a lot of festivals.
So James is not available for the time being.
No, he's taking care of his health.
Okay, so it's indefinite at this point. At this point, you're in the band for the foreseeable future.
We're rocking on really hard. We'll see where things go. But overall, the miss of Motörhead, I think we went out with a bang, a big crash. Fantastic way of finishing off the band. I couldn't believe that Lemmy actually could play, knowing that, we struggled on the European tour. But when he walked on stage, he was unbelievably good. And then he suffered from energy loss. No one thought he was going to pass away, but, you know. Well, he's up there, he's down here, he's somewhere, he's just laughing. And I kept saying every snare hit I do from now on till the end of my career will be a small tribute to Lemmy, the man and friend and bandmate that I had. You know, we lived together I lived with the boys for 25 years, so, you know. It's a lot of stuff happening, and we always were a band, as you know, that were touring all the time. So it was not like we're doing a world tour and then taking 3 years off. We kept playing, so obviously it's going to be happening a lot of stuff.
5 minutes off.
I'm sure he's very he's happy, he's proud about what he has done and what we have done. And, you know, people are honoring him everywhere. They're building stages for him, you know, and naming them stages and car races, and I mean, you know, no one can step into Lem's boots, you know, for sure, but you know, there is great bands out there, a new generation that kicks ass, you know.